Hello and welcome back to my channel. In today's video, I'm going to be showing you how to paint a floral watercolor piece using my flooded watercolor brushes. Before we jump into it, my goal when creating this pack was to utilize Procreate's features to replicate not just the look of watercolor, but the feel of painting with water on paper. So in addition to walking you through this floral project, I'm also going to be jumping in with some specific attributes of certain brushes, talking you through some of my favorites. If you want to get the brush pack, you can follow the link in the description below. Without further ado, let's get into it. Now the brush pack comes with 3 pre-made paper texture canvases, so you can jump into using one of those. As with all of my pre-made textures, there is a texture stack grouped on top and painting layers below. Now starting in on one of the painting layers, I'm going to begin by using the Diluted Floral Rough Brush. Here I have the size set to about 40%, and I'm going to show you some brush strokes first before we get into the actual floral painting. This brush specifically has quite a bit of dilution, so what that means is that it gives the appearance of having more water mixed in with the paint. The brush stroke starts out dark and then fades off the longer that it goes, leveling off at a somewhat consistent level of dilution. You can build up color with this brush by layering the strokes, and the brush will achieve a moderate level of saturation. It doesn't get super dark, it doesn't multiply together, but it will build up the layers of color. You can start to blend as you paint. This also means that it's great for blending different colors together. So you can switch colors and paint directly on top of the previous color. And then you can see here, I'm just smushing the pigment together to get this really nice watery blended effect. Now let's get into the florals. Starting with this lavender color, I'm going to draw in some initial flowers here, and I'm using the brush to form the petal shapes, varying my pressure to then vary the transparency of pigment. I like to paint the petals using one continuous brush stroke, keeping my pencil to the screen to push the pigment around. The rough edge texture of this brush feels really realistic to me, but if you want to achieve a more smooth effect, you can use less pressure and the brush will be smaller and therefore the edge will smooth itself out more. Next, I'm going to move on to the layer below the flowers, and I'm switching to use the watercolor Wizardry brush to draw in some stems in this teal color. After drawing in these stems in the teal, I'm going to switch to this blue-gray color to paint in some other stems, layering them in. I'm doing this to give a better sense of my composition, since I'm not working from a base sketch or anything. While I'm still on this layer, I'm going to switch to my eraser tool, which is set to the dipped flood brush, and I'm softly erasing any areas of stems that overlapped with the petals because these petals are somewhat translucent. For the purposes of demonstrating these brushes, I'm going to be switching brushes a lot, but typically I like to choose 2 or 3 to use in a painting and stick with those, and then vary it up depending on the look that I'm going for. Now I'm going to switch to this darker orange color, and I'm going to use the color Jitter Wizard brush. This is similar to the watercolor Wizardry brush with a few key differences. It has a sharper taper, and it also has some color variation built in, both within the stroke and between different strokes. So you can see, I'll zoom in here. You get some good color variation. It also has a hard outer edge like the watercolor Wizardry brush. I'm going to paint in some stems and leaves with this. But then just like with my previous stems layer, I'm going to use the eraser set to the dipped flood brush. I'm going to use this to just softly erase some of these overlaps. Next, I'm going to move back up to my flower layer, and I'm going to use this gold color. And on the Watery Brushy blend brush, I'm going to set the size here to about 20%, and I'm gonna add in, by just tapping, I'm gonna add in some goldenrod style flowers. Now this brush is a super blendable brush with a little more pigment to it and also has layerable color, but then it also has built-in color variation and a slight brush texture to it. So I really like it for things like this goldenrod, where what I do want is some built-in color variation. And then by tapping a bunch, I get a lot of this good scruffy brush texture. Now I'm going to add in one layer on top, and with this dark brown from my October palette, I'm going to use the old Scruff painter. So here I've increased my brush size to about 5% so I can get a slightly larger amount of pigment. And then this is a really fun brush that sort of replicates some of the happy accidents that you get in real watercolor. Then I'm going to move down to my greenery layer, and using this same teal from before, I'm going to use the Toothy painter brush to paint in some leaves. And so this brush also has a good amount of taper and then more of that rough edge and some blending capabilities. So you'll see that it starts to blend with the stems as I paint this. Now I don't want this to get too cluttered, so before I go any further, I'm gonna turn off this bottom layer and continue working on this greenery. I am using the dusky blue color, and I'm staying on the Toothy painter brush, and I'm going to reduce my brush size down to about 15% so that I can paint these in a slightly different shape. So to paint these leaves, I'm doing a large upstroke and keeping my pencil to the screen on the downstroke. Applying more pressure in the center and then tapering off at both ends. So I'm drawing each side of the leaf, one side on the upstroke and one side on the downstroke. Now I'm going to turn back on this bottom layer and rearrange a couple of these. So I'm selecting it with the freehand select tool and then tapping the transform arrow. I'm gonna move this off to the side for now. I like the color variation that this gives, but I definitely don't want this to get too busy. I'm gonna layer that in there. Okay, so now I want to add in some color variation within here. I'm not gonna add any more flowers or leaves, but I do want to enhance these ones. To do this, I'm going to go onto my flower layer, and I'm going to use the Watery Brushy blend brush. And with this, I'm going to add in some color and then use really light pressure to fade that out. Blending as I go. Next, I'm merging all of these layers together, and then I'm going to use my smudge tool to add in a water droplet effect. So I'm going to start with the watery pigment bleed brush on the smudge tool, size set to about 5%. I'm just going to dab this brush in some of the places where the stems overlap. And what this does is add this cooler wet on wet effect that almost makes it look like you just spilled or splashed some water on your page. And switching to the Floody smudge brush, I'm going to get a smoother blend on some of these. I can even go in and blend some of the different elements together and make the pigments bleed into one another. Thank you so much for watching. I hope that you enjoyed this. Hopefully you learned something. Definitely let me know if you have any questions or comments below. And if you paint something following this video and post it on Instagram, be sure to tag me in it. I love to see what you make. Thank you for hanging out and making art with me, and I will see you in the next one.